Hey guys, I'm just going to do a quick video here showing some of my airsoft guns. Do a quick review of my VFC M4 here for Aerosplat's custom gun contest. Don't know if it'll win, but I think it's pretty cool, and there might be some guys out there who actually enjoy looking at it. As you can tell, VFC M4, I got the gun from an Airsoft GI mystery box, $75. Got the $300 gun, a good starting point for this project. First thing I did was replace this handguard with this Magpul MOE handguard that I got off of eBay for $20 with the rails. I had to modify it a little bit by by grinding off some of the polymer inside here to fit in the delta ring. Works perfectly. The flashlight and the Magpul forward angle grip were given to me by a friend. They were free, they didn't cost me anything. The G&G SOCOM suppressor, I've had this thing forever. Don't know where I got it. I actually tapped this end of the barrel of the suppressor so that I could slide it over the outer barrel up against the handguard. That way I could get rid of the stock triangle sight and lock everything on with this. On the front, you can see obviously it's got the M-Bus sights from Magpul. These are on here purely because I found them on eBay. The front and the rear, the complete set, for $25 shipped. Normally they're like 70, up to 90 even. Back of the gun, got the UBR stock. Love this stock. I got this at eVike for $145. When it showed up, they didn't tell me that you need an adapter kit to make this thing fit. I ended up building my own in here out of some PVC, but it got on there tight and it locks just like it's supposed to. The next thing I did was put the Magpul Myad grip on here. You can see this is the one that I wanted with a finger grip. The only place I could find it was eHobby Asia in this color at that time. It was $55 from them. I sold the other grip that came in that kit on eBay for $25, so I spent a total of $25 on this to get my grip. You can see the quick detach sling from eVike. I think it was $8 for that. The other thing I did, since the VFCs have a working charging handle, I went ahead and got a Magpul bad lever on here. Again, that came off of eBay. I think I paid $21 shipped for it. I did have to modify this by milling off some of the bad lever metal and some of the metal on the actual bolt release itself. Lastly on here, you can see the ACOG scope. It is red green dot, non-magnifying, has the trademarks on the other side. You can't see them from this side. The mags I got for this gun are P mags. I actually have three of these, and then I found this one on eBay for $30, the P mag style 75 rounders with the fake shells, not on one side. They're actually on both sides, which is really, really nice. I wish I grabbed a couple of these. Anyways, the gun, like I said, is a VFC, so as far as internal in the gearbox, nothing needs to be replaced. The gun is pretty new, and there's no sense opening up a solid gearbox like that to replace stuff until things break. I did have issues with the hop-up not wanting to hold its position, so I went ahead and ordered Prometheus Neostrike hop-up and Prometheus soft-type bucking to go in here. The bucking was $17. I got the Neostrike hop-up unit for $45. Those I found on Airsoft GI. It was the cheapest price I could find. I also went ahead and replaced the inner barrel with a 6.01 type bore barrel. At the same time I did the hop-up. Great deal. The hop-up gave me 25 more FPS. Inside here, I took out the fuse, took out the stock plug, and replaced it with a Dean's plug to run the 11-1 LiPo I have in there. This is the old LiPo. The normal one is actually in there, so I can give you guys a quick little firing demonstration of this gun. The other thing you might have noticed is all of the etched-in lettering for Magpul. I went ahead and painted it with the red to highlight them all, even on top of the sights. That's not normally like that. Just one of those other little things I could do to make this gun unique in mine. Like I said, it shoots about 380 or so with 25s with this 11-1 LiPo that's in here. Get a pretty good rate of fire. about 30 rounds a second or so. That's 120 round mag that I emptied in 4 or 5 seconds. Anyways, the gun is, like I said, being entered in the custom gun contest. I'm personally looking forward to seeing everybody else's out there. Love this gun. If you like it, please vote for me. And thank you to Airslap for putting on a contest like that. If you guys have any questions about the other guns I have, go ahead and message me, and I'll explain the rest of these to you too. Again, thanks for watching, and good luck, everybody.